Hello guys, welcome live here to Racing Hot Bart Radio. Tonight's show, the preview for the Sprint Unlimited. Now, on tonight, first of all, we're going to get started off with a song that basically previews this, except there is one thing wrong with it. The song is The Boys Are Back in Town by Thin Lizzy. Now, if you want to, just go with it. Or, for this race, Danica Patrick is in it because she was the pole winner of last year's Daytona 500. So, imagine this. The song goes, the boys and girl are back in town. Work for that. Alright? So, here is your first song of the night. We'll be on the other side of the song. Let's go.
Change had much to say, but man, I still think them cats are crazy. They were asking if you were around, how you was, where you could be found. Told them you were living downtown, driving all the old men crazy. Shaking what she'd got. Man, when I tell you she was cool, she was red hot. I mean, she was steaming. And that time over at Johnny's place, well, this chick got up and she slapped Johnny's face. Man, we just fell about the place. If that chick don't wanna know, forget her. We'll be right back.
Well, the boys are back in town, of course. Now you add Danica Patrick into the lineup. Nothing on her. Nothing bad about Danica. She's a great race car driver and very proud, I guess, not to make this weird, very proud of her to be in the Sprint Unlimited. So, Sprint Unlimited is tonight here at there at Daytona. Race coverage starts at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Fox Sports 1. If you don't get Fox Sports 1, but you get the internet, head over to twitter.com/racinghotbot, or if you're on Twitter, at racinghotbot, to find live coverage of from us of the race. Now, it will only be text, and it will only be quick little tweets, but it will give you some idea of what's going on, right? That makes sense, right? Also, up on Facebook, you can click on the Twitter tab up in the top, on the tab section below the main cover page, the cover picture. There's a Twitter tab there. Click on that. That's your full live feed from Twitter to your Facebook account or Facebook page, as well as us. So, here we are. Race format was just announced 40 minutes ago. It is 30. Segment 1's 30 laps. Segment 2 is 25. Segment 3, third and final segment, is going to be 20 laps. Excuse me. Now, because of that, we're not going to have a 10-lap shooter or a 15-lap shootout. It's going to be a 20-lap shootout, meaning that almost every, well, if you want to get technical, the segments count down by fives, 30, 25, 20. I know, it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure that out. Point is, though, it's going to be a 20-lap shootout for the final segment. So, it's going to be interesting. Once again, Racing Hot will have coverage of that on Twitter. Total of 18 cars in the field. Here is your 18-car lineup, not actual starting order, because fans are still voting on that as we speak until 7:30, whether most career polls? Most career polls, last year's standings, or the final practice from yesterday. So, most career polls will be Jeff Gordon on the poll. Then, with the 2013 standings, it'd be Jimmy Johnson on the poll. And fastest from final practice would be Denny Hamlin on the poll. Go for the fastest practice. Not showing favoritism or anything. Let's just say this, guys. Jimmy Johnson, if you go with last year's point standing, Jimmy Johnson was slowest out of everybody in the practices yesterday. And Jeff Gordon was, okay. But, I don't know. It's up to you guys. So, here's the 18-car field. It goes Kyle Busch is one driver, Denny Hamlin, Joey Logano, Jimmy Johnson, Matt Kenseth, Ryan Newman, Dale Earnhardt Jr., Jeff Gordon, Carl Edwards, Marcus Ambrose, Kurt Busch, Kevin Harvick, Brad Keselowski, Jamie McMurray, Danica Patrick, Ricky Stenhouse Jr., Terry Labonte, and Tony Stewart. So that's the 18-car field that will race tonight. There was 20 cars eligible, but Kenny Schrader wasn't going to race in it because he is basically done with Sprint Cup Series racing, and Mark Martin is done fully. So, 18 cars. So, yeah. So, moving right along to our last topic of the night. Oops. Racing Hotspot Points Championship returns with this race tonight. Last year, we started our season off the Daytona 500. Now, we're starting our season off with the Sprint Unlimited as a specialty race. So, specialty race, the winner of this event, whether it be Dave, Joe, Art, or me, will get two extra points. Now, people in this, listening to this right now, are probably thinking, 2 extra points. Really? I don't care if I win. It's only 2 points. Well, last year, it was a very close, tight-knit championship, as Dave's probably listening to this right now, and he's nodding his head going, are you kidding me? It was crazy. Coming down to that last race at Homestead, if I swept him, me being Devin, swept him, I would have won the championship. This year, you're adding 2 more people, meaning that I believe that the points are going to be spread out, meaning our points totals at when we get to Homestead are going to be lower than what they were last year. So, every point counts, even if it is just 2 pesky extra points. It also gives you a leg up on the competition. So, now, here's something that is being officially announced right now on Racing Hotspot Radio for the first time to Racing Hotspot Nation. This finishing lineup, so depending on how we finish tonight, is going to determine the picking order for the Daytona 500. What do I mean by that? What I mean is, let's give an example. Ready? All right, so look here. Let's look here. All right. Okay, so here we go. We're going to say Dave. This is how we finish tonight. This is just a random order, and I don't believe it's going to finish this way. I'm pretty sure it's not going to. So this is how we finish tonight. Dave, Joe, Art, me. Darn it, I'm last again, even in a random draw. You got to be kidding me. So that's how it finishes. Dave, Joe, Art, me. So, how do we pick for the 500? Dave, guess what? You get to pick first. Excuse me. You get to pick first. Joe picks second. Art picks third. I pick last, of course. So, that's just an example. Is it going to happen that way? I doubt it. Anything's possible. So, that is what I'm basically saying, is that the way we finish tonight is the way we'll pick for the 500. So, yep. So here's our picks. Picks for the Sprint Unlimited, which I have to admit, and I apologize, being the Racing Hotspot spokesman, Racing Hotspot everything guy, I didn't do my research good enough. And I apologize to you players in this points championship. Those of you who are listening probably right now. Let's say this. Some of the drivers that our guys picked aren't in the race. For example, Casey Kane. Joe picked Casey Kane for second. He's not in the race. Art picked Casey Kane for fourth. He's not in the race. Dave picked Brian Vickers for fifth. He's not in the race. Right? I believe he's not. Yep, he is not. No, well, those are the only 3 drivers. Well, I look at it this way, though, because I don't believe this is going to be an unfair disadvantage to us players, because the way they pan out is different positions. What it just means is that Dave isn't going to win fifth. It goes down to me, Art, and Joe. Joe's not going to win second. It goes down to Art, Devin, me, and Dave. Art's not going to win fourth. It goes down to Dave, me, and Kyle Busch. Hold on a minute here. Huh. Dave, if you were listening to this right now, email me. Because how did you not pick up on that all 5 of my drivers are in the race and everybody else has at least one that's not? Yes. Dave, if you are listening to this right now, email me about that. Because I keep setting myself up to look like I'm cheating when I'm not. Darn it. All right. Like I said, Dave, if you're listening to this, email me. My email is open. I'm actually curious to see if you're actually listening. Still nothing. Okay. So, here's our picks for the Sprint Unlimited, which starts in about an hour and 10 minutes. So about 80 minutes. Joe Mackey over in Vermont. If you're listening to this, Joe, hello. Here we go. So Joe has Tony Stewart for fifth, which, by the way, we'll talk about Tony in a second. Kyle Busch for fourth. Matt Kenseth for third. Casey Kane for second. Ouch. Sorry, Joe. And Dale Earnhardt Jr. for the win. Not a bad driver to pick for the win, because he always finishes second at Daytona, and it looks like this might be his night. No comment on that. Art, there we go, has Matt Kenseth for fifth, Casey Kane for fourth, I'm sorry, Art, Jimmy Johnson for third, Kyle Busch for second, and Carl Edwards. First. Carl Edwards isn't that bad. He's a good pick. Really, last year he didn't have the best speed weeks. What I mean by that is he was called 5-time by Dale Waltrip at Phoenix because of it. If you know what I mean, he wrecked 5 different cars. Which he hasn't wrecked any. But by this time, Speed Weeks last year, he already had 3 cars on the way home to Charlotte. All right, my picks. I have Danica Patrick for fifth. I believe she's going to do well tonight. She might win it. If she wins it, she's in it for the rest of her racing career in Cup Series. That's pretty cool. But I believe she's going to do pretty well. Jimmy Johnson for fourth. Like I said, he was the slowest. Tony Stewart for third. Kevin Harvick for second in that number 4 Budweiser Chevy. Still not used to seeing that 4 car on the track, but I like it. And Kyle Busch for the win. Rowdy was pretty good last year. We'll see how he does for me. Dave, last but not least. Well, maybe last. And least. Just kidding, Dave. All right. Dave has Brian Vickers for fifth. Sorry, Dave. Carl Edwards for fourth. Jeff Gordon for third. Matt Kenseth for second. And Kurt Busch in that number 41. And first for the win. All right. So, quick little thing here. 2 things on Stuart Haas Racing. Actually, 3 things. Kurt Busch's number, the number 41. I don't know if you guys know this. Kurt Busch's number 41 was made up because they said, hey, you know, we got a lot of extra 14s laying around. All right. And we'll take it 41. Bingo! Now, if you understand that, you'll understand this. Kevin Harvick's car, number 4. Yeah, they had a lot of 14s laying around. Okay, so. Now, Tony Stewart returned yesterday to another NASCAR Spring Cup Series after being on the injured list since August. What was his reaction when he got in the car? Well, it was a big fat smile. He was happy to be in that car, and he was out there most of the practice. A couple of times, his crew chief was like, hey, Tony, you gotta come in. And he's like, what? I can't hear you. Can't hear him, huh? Sorry. So, that was pretty interesting. But he was really happy with the car. He enjoyed his time in it. And, like I said, he was really happy with it. Hold on. What the? Is he still in the car? Huh. Wonder if... I think he needs to be taken out. Sorry. I'm just kidding. That sounded more like an Indy car instead of a cup car. Wait a minute here. Does Juan Pablo Montoya know that Indy car doesn't run on Daytona? Okay, that was bad too. I'm very sorry. So, still no email from Dave. What does that prove? He's not listening. We got about 8 minutes. 8.5 minutes left on the show. So, here we go. Just make sure there's nothing here on Twitter that I need to talk about. Here we go. Stuart Haas Racing, as well as Bobby Labonte. Well, let me rephrase that. Danica Patrick, Tony Stewart, and Bobby Labonte all are changing out engines right now in their Daytona 500 cars. Why? Because they blew up. The engines blew up. So, that is Hendrick Motors right there. So everybody was afraid. Hendrick Motors covers this. Ready? All of Stuart Haas Racing. All of Hendrick Motorsports. All of Chip Ganassi, the two cars of McMurray and Kyle Larson, sorry, and Bobby Labonte. Bobby Labonte's on a no-name team. He's running just the 500, I believe. I'm speculating that for an Indy car that took a long time to go around Daytona. Alright, no more sound effects. Sorry. So Kyle Larson in that 42 and Bobby Labonte, like I said, no name team. Those 11 drivers. Did I count that right? Yes, 11 drivers have Hendrick Motors. And they're all afraid to go out on the track because they think that their engine is going to blow up. So what does that mean? Look for the 4 SHR cars tonight on the Sprint Unlimited. The 3 Hendrick Motorsports cars. And dang it, my iPod just died. 3 Hendrick Motorsports cars. Those 7 cars tonight, keep an eye on them because they might be in trouble when it comes to motors tonight. So I'm a little afraid since I'm a Tony Stewart fan. But yeah. Alright, so can't really think of anything else to talk about. Those last few topics were just add-ons. Literally, I just thought of them in my mind and went, oh, let's throw those in. Weekend Roundup returns this Tuesday. We're recording it tomorrow night, but we will publish it on Tuesday. So, yes. Here's a look at your Speed Week's Speed Week's schedule. All right. Hold on one second. Sorry. Okay. Speed Week schedule. Tomorrow is Daytona 500 qualifying. Front rows will be set. Tuesday night will be the Battle at the Beach, which they will race on the super stretch of the back straightaway at Daytona on that quarter mile oval they build. Thursday will be the Budweiser Duels at Daytona. I look forward to watching those. Those are on under the lights this year. Friday is the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series race. They kick off their season. Saturday is NASCAR Nationwide Series season opener. And Sunday is the Daytona 500. So that's a week look. Racing Hotspot will be following the Budweiser Duels under hashtag RHDuels. The Truck Series under hashtag RHFollowLive. And the Daytona 500 under hashtag RH500. Okay, so. And plus, Racing Hotspot Weekend Roundup returns on February. Well, returns tomorrow or Tuesday with just me. And then returns in full swing next Sunday. Is returning next Sunday, February 23rd, with Dave and I full-time. So, looking forward to that. So, with about 2.5 minutes left, we're actually going to say goodbye. One more time here. With the boys are back in town, just to close this out. Why not? Actually, we're going to choose a different one. My songs Know What You Did in the Dark by Fall Out Boys, a.k.a. Light 'em up, 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 light 'em up, up, up. Because that's just going to prove to you what we should expect tonight as far as the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series Sprint Unlimited. So, remember, hashtag RHUnlimited for following broadcast of the Sprint Unlimited. But until we talk to each other again, here's Fall Out Boys.